So far, no one has actually ever seen a black hole. And so we were able for the first time to actually take an image of a black hole and make it visible to everyone.
What you have to do is to build a telescope that's able to see a mustard seed in New York as seen here from Europe. And to do this, you have to create a telescope the size of the world to see something that small as a black hole at a distance of many millions of light years.
This telescope is 100 meters in diameter, but it's not enough. You want a bigger telescope, and of course it's impossible to build, but you can create a virtual telescope.
So what we do is we combine telescopes all over the world into one big telescope, observing at the highest radio frequencies you can observe. And then you can see the shadow of a black hole.
So if you try to look into the center of galaxies, it's usually blocked from view by dust and other stuff. In the radio, you can look through, like here today, we can look through rain, you can look through clouds, and so we can look through dust. And with combining radio telescopes like this together with other telescopes in the world, you can peer right into the center of the galaxy and see this black hole.
And you need digital equipment that records a lot of data. And that is actually only possible now.
Black holes are a prediction of theories of gravity that should absorb everything, including light.
Not all of this light actually goes into the black hole, luckily, and that's why we can produce an image. And we have to compare the image that we simulate through computer programs with the image that we actually measure through observations.
Well, we had the idea 20 years ago, but to realize it, you have to bring the world together.
So astronomers always have a track record of working together despite what's going on in the world, even during the Cold War or earlier, Einstein and Edison, even though the First World War was breaking out, they still communicated on relativity and experiments. And so we came also together here. So if we really work together, we can achieve much more than alone.
Black holes tell you that there are regions inside them that cannot be explored. And for a physicist, this is very disturbing and attractive at the same time, because, you know, we don't like to have doors which we cannot cross. And in particular, inside black holes, physics is even expected to fail completely. And so this even adds fascination to these objects.
I think the funding from Europe made all the difference. It helped us to make a big impact in the entire project.
And working worldwide with our collaborators, this has become possible. It's a really global endeavor at the heart of Europe.
And enabled us to do this observation in 2017 smoothly and very swiftly. The very first attempts were made here in Europe in the middle of the 90s. And then the technique developed further. And then 2017, for the first time, we had all the telescopes lined up. And surprisingly, it worked at the very first try. This usually doesn't happen.
We're really about to announce a huge breakthrough for humanity. We are about to take a picture of something that one man alone, dreamt, imagined 100 years ago in 1915. Albert Einstein imagined that this idea that a very big weight transforms geometry, that when the mass is too heavy, you make a hole, a mysterious hole, where nothing can get out of it, where all it's absorbed.
We are looking into space, towards a galaxy, a giant galaxy, 500 billion kilometers away from us. Very big galaxy, which was suspected to host a supermassive black hole in the very center. 101 years ago, someone discovered a streak of light, which is plasma shooting out of the center of the Milky Way, marking the supermassive black hole. I never believed that this black hole was as big as people said, until we saw that. This is the nucleus of the galaxy M87, and this is the first ever image of a black hole.